It's gon' show.
They turn it up for me.
It's gon' show.
They make that shit bang.
Yeah, it's gon' show. Let's get them up. It's gon' show. It's gon' show. It's gon' show.
But EDIDON is a new and improved Edie, you know what I'm saying? Another side of Malcolm. This is my original, this is my real name, you know what I'm saying? But EDIDON was just another way to keep reinventing myself, you know what I mean? A wise man in this game told me a long time ago to keep reinventing yourself. And so that's what I'm doing with EDIDON, the Hope Dealer, and everything, just putting a new spin on what people know me for. Or know me as.
Do it, it's a cruel world, can't trust the soul. Loyalty is dead, being live between love and hate.
Oh man, just some new music, you know what I mean? Some new messages, and just a whole new project that I'm putting together right now. I'm taking my time with, but it's coming together real good. I'm real proud of it already. I can't wait for people to hear it. It's almost a fight every day, and I can just release everything I've been working on. You know what I'm saying? But timing is everything. So I'm going to do it at the right pace and at the right time. But it's definitely coming soon. You know what I mean? I just appreciate the interest out there from everybody. And, you know, stay tuned.
It's gonna show. It's gonna show. It's gonna show. You got the money. It's gonna show. That's for sure.
I got a lot of plans, but I just share with y'all a couple of them. First of all, of course, I'm going to release the Hope Dealer project at some point this year. Also, I'm writing. Constantly writing the blogs, the books. You know, that's a new passion of mine. I say it's a new passion, but I've always been a writer, and I guess I just fell back on it because I was doing music so much. And now that I'm at this point in my life, I'm doing some more writing. So you'll definitely see a lot more blogs, you know, definitely a book this year, and more books in the future on a wide array of different subjects. You know what I'm saying? My first book is a fictional crime story set within the rap world, and it's crazy, you know what I mean? I use a lot of different events that I went through personally, a lot of shit that I've seen, to build these characters and make these characters come to life in this book. Well, I decided not to talk for a couple of reasons. First, personal reasons in my life, you know, people in my family, you know, getting older and needing a little bit more of my attention and also my children. You know what I'm saying? It's widely known. Everybody knows I got children. I have, you know, five biological children and one stepdaughter that are very important to me. You know what I'm saying? And I've been working and traveling and being on the road for so many years. I missed a lot of, you know, little things that are really big things in their world. So I decided to fall back and really focus more on them, to focus more on myself and some personal goals that I got, like writing a book and getting the Hope Dealer done. And I just felt like, you know, touring and doing a lot of traveling would impede on that and slow that process down. And that's really the important shit, you know what I'm saying? Not to say the fans and touring and seeing all these beautiful countries and cities is not important, because it's definitely, you know, great. It's something that I always cherish, but you know, you can't get those moments back in your family's life, you know what I mean? And you know, I decided to go ahead and fall back this year, and you know, maybe next year too, you know, as far as touring with the Outlaws, you know what I'm saying? I don't know when I'll do that again, but right now this is my focus, you know what I mean? My family, my books, you know, the Hope Dealer and things like that. Well, the producers on the Hope Dealer are a lot of up and coming cats, but they're already heavy in the game as far as I'm concerned. They're major in the game just with their talent alone. You know what I'm saying? I don't want to give away too much, but I definitely say I got a record with SIBO, and I got a record with Trans Lee. Y'all don't know about Trans Lee, get up on him. You know what I'm saying? He definitely one of the cats in the game that got next. But I'm still working on it. You know what I mean? More features probably end up on the project. But that's just it for right now. It's a whole lot of me, though. You know what I'm saying? I feel like, you know, as far as me and the whole Outlaws thing, I'm the only member of the Outlaws that never did anything solo. You know what I'm saying? I really just put out my first solo record on Illuminati 2K10, which was Reach for the Sky. You know what I'm saying? I always was, you know, a team player. Anybody else get their shine on, you know what I'm saying? I just want to see it work. I just want to see it go. You know what I'm saying? So this year I decided to say, you know what? Let's give E.D.I a shot. Let's see what E.D.I can do, you know what I'm saying, on his own. And it's been like a breath of fresh air to me. You know what I'm saying? It's hard sharing them bars. You know what I'm saying? You got to share bars with 4 or 5 niggas. You don't really get a chance to say what you want to say, and you don't really get a chance to let people know who you are and what you about. You know what I'm saying? So people just assume, you know what I'm saying? They say birds of a feather flock together, so they just assume that, you know what I'm saying? Okay, well, if I know Pop, then I know all of them, but we all individuals, and we all have individual outlooks on life and, you know what I'm saying, different passions and shit, you know what I mean? And so on and so forth. So with the Hope Dealer, you'll get a chance to know E.D.I. You'll get a chance to know Michael. You'll get a chance to know E.D.I. Dog. You'll get a chance to know the Hope Dealer, you know what I'm saying? And, it's all out there in the music.
One by one.
First track is coming real soon. Definitely before the end of the month. I'm going to drop the first record off the Hope Dealer. My only problem is that I got so much good material, I really have a hard time picking the first record, to be honest with y'all. I'm going to just be completely honest. You know, I got 3 records that I feel like should come out first, but each day is a new favorite, you know what I mean? And that's not to put no extras on it, right? Because the music is real personal to me, so, you know, I love it, you know what I'm saying? If y'all like it, then that's great, you know what I'm saying? But I love it, so it's just about picking the first record and saying that's the record I'm going to go with. But I think I made that decision, so y'all definitely be hearing it within the next couple of weeks. I'm going to drop it with a blog first. Drop a blog, and then that record will be attached to it, and then we're just going to blast it out to all the DJs and on the streets going to have it, and you'll be able to find it everywhere. But it's going to be on the blog first on o-4-l.com. Yeah, I was a little surprised, but not like, wow, you know, the blogs are successful. You know, I really just started writing the blogs as a way to express myself and, you know, say some things that I couldn't say on a record. You know what I'm saying? Or couldn't really put the music. And if people enjoyed it, then that was even better. But, you know, with the love that it's getting and, the high praise I get from people that read me saying they enjoy my writing and I should write a book, I should write a movie. That's you know, encouragement is always good, so I love that, you know what I'm saying? And salute to all those people that really appreciate what I'm writing. You know, all y'all words of encouragement is real good for me and real good for my confidence in this writing thing I'm jumping in right now. Right, Letter to the President was, of course, about Trayvon Martin. And it was just about me, you know, seeing all the media coverage on it. Really hearing the story from whatever the media was putting out there. You know, you always got to take what they put out there with a grain of salt. But when I started to write the blog, it was almost like something took over. And, you know, I became Trayvon for a minute. And I really was dead, you know, actually feeling and seeing what he was going through. And it just came out like in a letter form, like a Barack could read it. Yeah, definitely true. You know, on the weight loss part, since 2010, I've lost about 65 pounds, and I'm gonna keep off. I replaced with muscle, and but more importantly, I changed, you know, my eating habits. A lot of people think just working out, exercising, dieting, that's the way to lose weight and be healthy, but you know, nobody tells you to change your eating habits because a lot of shit out there that's provided for us to eat is garbage. You know what I'm saying? So I had to first do that. And that was real difficult because I enjoy eating whatever I wanted to eat. You know what I'm saying? I figured, you know, I didn't eat pork. I didn't eat a lot of beef. I thought I had good eating habits. But when you really break down what I was putting into my body, I had very poor eating habits and so did a lot of people around me. So I had to, you know, stop eating what I was eating. And you know, part of that meant not being around people that was, you know, in the same place and wasn't ready to change. You know, it's kind of like almost drug addiction. If you're going to get off, if you're going to get off drugs, you're going to get off coke or whatever, you can't be around a bunch of cokeheads every day because it's going to be even harder. So I had to really change my whole lifestyle, you know what I'm saying? And that's really what I did, you know. And then I continued working out, and that's when I started to see the weight come off, and it's coming off more and more every day. The cigarette smoking is a little harder. Some days I'm off, some days I'm on. I'm back and forth, but I decided by June 1st, I'm going to just go ahead and thug it out and really quit, you know, smoking. I smoked for 10 years before, and then I quit cold turkey, and then I started back up. You know what I'm saying? So I know I can do it again. And, you know, with the herbal stimulation, I'll be all right. You know what I'm saying? But even that is something that you got to curb and control. You can't let it control you.
Trying to find our way. I never knew that money in the bank would be our way. I lost a lot along the way.
Man, the best thing I can tell you is mind over matter. You know what I'm saying? One thing somebody told me that quit smoking is constantly challenge yourself every day to say, is the cigarette stronger than me? You know what I'm saying? Or am I stronger than the cigarette? You know, and sometimes it works for me. Some days I'll be like, yo, man, fuck that shit. I need a cigarette. But like I said, I set a goal for myself, and I'm going to stick to it, and I'm going to keep all the OPLers out there updated on my battle with cigarette smoking. You know what I'm saying? And if you're out there smoking them cigarettes, you can't do it forever, man, because consequences and repercussions come with anything in life. You know, too much of anything is a habit. We should never want habits. The only habit we should want really is breathing. The new OPL shirt will be available by June 1st. I appreciate the amazing love and support for the first OPL shirts. The red, white, and the blues has been very successful. And I appreciate all that love out there, everybody supporting that. You know, we send orders out to Africa, Germany, Russia, Italy, you know, as well as all over the United States. Shout out to Canada. They've been a heavy supporter. So look for new designs that are not even outlaw related, but all the shirts that have a message, something to make you think and the people that see your shirt think. You know what I'm saying? So, you know, and it's all always going to be fly. We always going to have our fashion sense. You know what I'm saying? And I just want the line to grow. You know, if my dreams come true, it'll be one of the biggest T-shirt lines out there. You know what I'm saying? And something that stands the test of time. And I'm not banking on the success of the T-shirts just because it's outlaw related or it's outlaw affiliated. I really want the shirts to be able to stand on their own. So, actually, the OPL shirt that you're seeing now that's for sale is actually, we're not going to be doing those anymore once the new designs come in. You know, those will be plastic, custom made only. You know, of course, the price is going to be a little bit higher. You'll be able to get rhinestones in them. You'll be able to have it custom made. If you want your name on it, we'll be able to put your name on it. But it will not be at the price that it is right now, which is $20. The price is going to go up for the original OPL shirts. All the other designs will be at the same price. And ladies, trust me, I have not forgotten about y'all. The baby tees are coming in. Be true is the slogan for the ladies line. And those will be ready by June 1st as well. We got the baby tees for the summer. And you know, you can rock a t-shirt year round. So those will always be up year round. We're going to start a special OPL website. You'll always be able to go to o-4-l.com to get them. But we'll have another website where you can get a wide array of other products that we're going to be giving out there to the people. So definitely stay tuned for the new shirts. They're coming out by June 1st. They're being worked on right now. I'm slightly cracking the whip on my people because I've been telling all the OPLers out there that these shirts been coming and they ain't been up. And that's a problem. You know, I like my shit to be up on point when I say it's going to be there. But mark my words, by June 1st, you'll be able to get the new designs. We're going to have 3 to 4 new designs, as well as the female baby tees. When she go in, little mama ain't playing. Oh yeah, on that website you'll be able to get natural hair products for ladies who rock their natural. You know what I'm saying? You'll definitely be able to get natural hair products. Log on to DivaWellnessSalon.com for more information on those hair products. And but we'll be doing those. Like I said, we'll be doing the female baby tees. We'll be doing male t-shirts and all different kind of color schemes. And, you know, just stay tuned for more. You'll definitely be able to, you know, get my book. Once my book is done there, you'll be able to, you know, cop the Hope Dealer once the Hope Dealer is done and ready for the world. You know what I'm saying? But that website will definitely be, you know, a place you can go to once you finish with O-4-L.com.
She feel the sweetest thing. She a see her little boyfriend leave.
Yeah, you know, continue to support the Outlaws and the whole O4L movement. You know what I'm saying? Keep rocking with us all the way forward, whether it's solo or whether it's as a group. You know how we do. The Hope Dealer is being mixed and it's almost done. First record is coming in a couple of weeks with my next blog. Appreciate the love and the support for all the blogs, you know what I mean? Everybody that's rocking with that blog life, I really appreciate that shit, man, because that means a lot to me. It's something that I'm doing that's not music related. So, you know, anytime you get support for non-music related things when you're an artist, it's a big deal. So I once again, salute to all the O4Lers out there. You know, last but not least, salute to you, Vegas, you know what I'm saying, for rocking with us and for rocking with me personally and keeping this O4L thing going. You know, I started the whole O4L catchphrase in 2009, and it's just caught on, you know what I'm saying? And everybody that hashtag O4L on Twitter, I'm down with the movement, so salute. It's EDIDON, the Hope Dealer.
Ladies and gentlemen,
yeah, you can contact me on Twitter at the Outlaws, at the Real EDIDON, Facebook. I got my own fan page, Official EDI Main. Go on there, like that. I'm gonna be updating that soon with a lot of, you know, the songs is gonna be there and the videos and all of that shit. Of course, I'm on Facebook at EDI Main, EDIDON, my Facebook page. Case. I don't even know the name of that shit. But, you know, you can find me all on Facebook. Definitely email me at thehopedealer@O4L.com. If you're looking for a feature, if you're looking for beats, you know what I'm saying? If you want to send me some beats, that's the email to send that to. You know what I mean? Or you can reach out to Vegas to get it to me. You know what I'm saying? And shout out to all the O4Lers out there, man. Salute. Oh, yeah, definitely check me out on Instagram, EDIDON. Again, that's Instagram, EDIDON. You can follow me on there. Like I said, Twitter, at the Real EDIDON. Facebook, Official EDI Mean. There it is, and there it was.
Currency, I'm pricey. Don't bring your wifey around me. It ain't about me. It's the limelight. She heard the rumors she wanna see. You can't blame it